been a record year for deal making in 2021. Through the first three quarters of the year, global mergers and acquisition activity reached an all-time high, with more than 27,000 deals completed for a total combined value of $3.4 trillion. We're welcoming in DataCite's Chief Revenue Officer, Todd Albright, now for more. Todd, thank you so much for joining us this afternoon. Looking back at the incredible volume of deal making this year, what do you think were the biggest factors in the market environment that really contributed to this?
Well, it's very nice to be with you, Emily, and on the show today. I have to say, we've been in a bull market for M&A since June of 2020. If you look at the deals that have been happening on our platform, we're up year to date 34% year on year. And again, it's all the more astonishing as we lap COVID. Keep in mind, the deals that we're seeing on our platform are at inception, not at announced deals. So we get visibility on the market 6 to 9 months of when they actually happen. But again, you're looking at a low interest rate environment, and particularly in this age of COVID, you're looking at companies future-proofing their business through very aggressive moves, particularly in technology, where deal volumes, according to our data, were up 44% year on year. And then particular combinations that would increase competitiveness into the future.
Well, let's talk about that low interest rate environment and also the fact that the Fed is tapering. A lot of this is liquidity driven. So we might have slightly higher interest rates next year. But I'm noting in your survey of 600 deal makers that 48% of them expect that the M&A blitz will continue to increase and we'll have another record year in 2022. Just your thoughts on this in general.
Well, there is nothing in our data that suggests otherwise. And again, we did survey 600 deal professionals. And again, deal professionals or deal makers in our parlance are investment bankers, corporate finance professionals, private equity professionals, and all the advisors, legal, tax, and otherwise that serve the M&A industry. And the view is with, though the Fed may be tapering and though we may see an increase in interest rate, that doesn't change the fact that from a historical perspective, there are, you know, really low interest rates and ample private capital, particularly in the private equity communities on the sideline, and then debt financing available as well. So we expect it to continue to rise.
In reference to your survey, again, 71% of respondents said that inflation impacted an M&A deal they worked on this year. In what ways specifically did you see inflation impacting the deal-making space?
Well, it really affected, you know, deal valuations is the cost of capital kept going down, but, you know, the cost of doing business kept going up. And so that impacted it to some degree. You know, a secondary factor just could be on overall business metrics and performance going forward. We'll see how this plays out over the next couple of months. But as you noted earlier in the survey, the majority of the acquisitions we're hearing from our deal makers going forward are really going to be focused on growth. And that growth will come organically from the companies that they buy, but also revenue synergies where you're bundling the products you have with the products you acquire to try to drive that growth.
And I was just going to ask you that. So I'm going to ask you a little separate question here. Another fact from your report, 89% of deal makers were more selective in choosing dates to move forward with in 2021 this year due to bandwidth constraints, high valuations, or macroeconomic concerns. Sounds like there could be a lot of pent-up demand just from the deals that couldn't be made this year because everybody was too busy. Your thoughts on this? Is that your conclusion? Or is this just, do we have enough space in 2022 to make it a record year, a banner year on its own?
Well, it's a very astute point, Jared. I mean, what we saw is if you looked at sort of earlier, you know, in the fourth quarter, we saw a bit of a slowdown as people were trying to conclude deals. But what we've seen in the last 6 to 8 weeks is that move up and to the right again, deals on our platform up 34%. That's not stopping in the fourth quarter. And we agree with you that one of the things that has frankly slowed, again, we're on a torrid pace of M&A, but if there's anything slowing it down, it's probably the human intensive work that goes into completing a due diligence process. And so what we see a lot of forward leading firms doing, these are M&A advisories, again, corporate finance professionals, is they're really looking to technology, and that's where we fit. Again, we're a utility, workflow, content management, all very secure, that helps deal makers complete deals more quickly. We're investing in AI technologies that basically automate and streamline the process of preparing, serving up diligence materials, and then interrogating and performing due diligence on an automated basis. And so what I think you're going to see is relief in that human intensive work through the application of technology. That's kind of where DataCite fits in the process.
What's your outlook next year for SPAC mergers? Because, of course, we had a really strong start to 2021 in terms of that kind of deal making. Petered out a little bit in the middle and back half of this year. So where do you think we're headed on that front in 2022?
Hard for me to predict. But again, our indicators say that the SPAC markets will continue to be strong, if only because you've had a record number of launches this year. And These blank check companies have to do deals within the next 2 years. And so the fact that you've had a number of issuance, that's going to put pressure on the market to do deals. And so we would expect SPACs and DSPACs to continue.
And I just want to kind of turn back to your response about the technology that you use. I started doing due diligence in the mid 90s, and I was using a phone, a paper and pen, email was kind of just being invented or just being adopted. What are some of the tools, especially in the pandemic era, that people are using in lieu of a lot of the face-to-face meetings that used to happen and aren't happening as frequently as now?
I mean, Jared, whenever you want to get back in the M&A industry, you're welcome to talk with us at DataCite. But I think the biggest thing is, you know, a lot of M&A was happening, you know, face-to-face prior to the pandemic. And then all of a sudden we moved to an era of Zoom-enabled meetings. And so you have less travel, you have more meetings going on in Zoom. And that's not just mergers and acquisitions, it's IPO roadshows, it's financings, it's capital raisings. Now all these things are happening much more efficiently. I was talking with an investor the other day, he's about to raise a new multi-billion dollar fund. And I said, are you hitting the road? And they actually built a studio within their offices to basically do all of their fundraising virtually. And so that transformation to doing this work virtually, and obviously I can't help myself, but a lot of the investments that companies like DataCite are making, particularly with respect to, you know, artificial intelligence and allowing, you know, the rich history of M&A, allowing that to inform automated completion of work and tasks, as opposed to what previously had been done manually by more junior professionals in this industry, that too is accelerating matters.
All right, we'll leave it there for now. Todd Albright, DataCite Chief Revenue Officer, thank you so much for your time.